Today on Getting Hitty With It, a great shadow has fallen across the kingdom. Could be worse. Could be raining. My name is Craig Duhigg, and I'm reviewing Darkest Night. Darkest Night is a cooperative board game for 1 to 4 players. Designed by Jeremy Leonard, the game is from Victory Point Games. Choose your heroes. The base game ships with 9 to select from. Each has power cards giving you the special traits and abilities. Grace represents your life, and secrecy signifies how loudly you move and whether the bad guy can hear you. Each hero gets a turn indicator that allows players to change the order of player turns. This can aid in the turn order strategy your group leverages to take out the baddies. To start the round, there are special character powers that can affect your hero at the start of their turn. You can also lose a sanity point by being in the same location as the necromancer or if you have the holy relic in tow. If you have ventured out of the monastery, you draw an event card. Events include all sorts of bad things to fight or affect you or the game. Deck renewal is a card that has you reshuffle the deck when it's drawn. There are plenty of actions for your hero to take. Some give you 1 secrecy point, like traveling to an adjacent location, or hiding. Hiding also refreshes your powers. If you are hanging out in the monastery, why not try your luck at praying by rolling 2 dice? For every 3 or higher you roll, you get 1 life force added and refresh all your powers. You can attack a blight at your current location. Roll a die that is equal to or greater than their might, and the combat was a success. If it wasn't a success, you suffer the failure consequences. You can always choose to elude if you are not as powerful as your opponent. Win, lose, or elude, you always lose 1 secrecy in battle. Search a location by rolling 2 dice to see if you are successful in searching. If you roll the number that is equal to or greater than the search difficulty number, you were successful. Select a map card to see what you found. There are a lot of cool items like artifacts that can be equipped to your hero, such as keys, magic potions, treasure chests, charms, and supply caches. Have your hero retrieve a holy relic after collecting 3 keys. This will allow you to ultimately defeat the necromancer. However, carrying around a holy relic also makes you a little more noticeable to the bad guy. Your heroes also pack a punch with power effects from their character's card. Near the end of your turn, you will also have to defend any blights that are in your location. Turn over their tile to see if you have to fight them or if there is an effect to that location. This is just a higher than normal view of everything that can happen during a turn. There are so many different types of actions, modifiers, and card effects that make this game really fun to play. After all the heroes have taken their turn, it's time to find out where the necromancer is going and what he is spreading. You check its movement based on the die indicators at its current location. We roll the 5, which sends him to the village. Draw a map card to find out what blight was spawned. In this case, it's an evil presence based on the village location. After his move is finished, the darkness tracker is advanced, which gives him more power. Reset all the turn tokens and you are ready to go again. You win the game by either killing the necromancer with a holy relic in tow, or by gathering 3 holy relics in the monastery. The only way to lose is by having the monastery become overrun with blights. What do we like about this game? The game strikes a nice balance between a lot of things going on, but not too much that you become overwhelmed. The box version comes with a thick, laser-cut game board and game pieces. The quality of the artwork is also impressive. Clark Miller and Daniel Taylor did a nice job setting the mood. We were pleasantly surprised by this title. What don't we like about this game? The game ships with a soot wipes a lot napkin. The laser cut wood pieces, which we love, leave a black laser dust that gets everywhere. It can take a couple of plays to get it all off the game pieces. The box that the game comes in could end up getting damaged. The slide over cover will get banged up or ripped. We plan on pulling this game out a lot, and it's bound to happen. I long for a proper game box for this title. On the board flip meter, Darkest Night is a harder title to get up and running with. You will find yourself referencing the manual during your first couple of plays. Once you get up and going, though, the game is a lot of fun attempting to corner and kill the necromancer. Darkest Night sits in the number 7 spot on our top 10 list. Welcome back! This is a fun dice-rolling fantasy adventure game with a manageable amount of board goings-on. Like, favorite, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching. I'm Craig Duhigg, and until next time, get higgy with Darkest Night. Okay, we didn't make any bloopers this time, but check out these other videos for us. Take a look at what we've done before and, well, have a good day.